Hi class, now I'm going to show you how to analyze your data with SciDAVis. So we open up SciDAVis, we do an ASCII import, and we open up a CSV file of our data. I'm using the static method. Our data is comma separated. I'm going to open it up with Notepad and show you that. The first line of the data tells you the name of the headers, time and radians, and the columns are separated by commas. So we're good to go. These parameters are good. So we open it, and there's our columns. Time is on the x-axis. That's what the x is in square brackets. Let's plot y. We do a scatter plot, and straight away we see we've got crap data, because on the right-hand side, we've got low frequency, and on the left-hand side, the frequency is higher. The bumps are closer together in time. So this data isn't going to work, but we're going to analyze it anyway, and we'll just have to take better data at a later value. To analyze it, we'll go up to Analysis, to the Fit Wizard, and we're going to go to a user-defined function that I loaded in already, and you have to click that box, we're going to fit with that. This is a user-defined function, it's equation 2 from the manual. It's in this particular text file, so you don't even have to type it out. It's equation 2. I have to put T minus T0 in it, because this equation depends on you starting at T equals 0. So we're going to go from X equals, you have to find some peak. That's how this, if you read the manual, that's how the data works. And it turns out there's a peak at 108.9 seconds. You do that by scrolling through the data and you'll see. So we're going to start from x equals 109 to x equals 600. Then we're going to give it some initial values. It looks like TE is the theta equilibrium. It looks like it's around 10 milliradians, so we'll give it that. These other we have to fix that constant value x0, because that's where we're starting from. We're not allowed to vary that. Then we do a fit, and we immediately see that our frequency is 0.025, more or less. This gives you the error bars and everything. So this is all your error analysis is done in this. Now let's go to the right-hand side, and we're going to do a fit to the wobbles the wobbles after we've moved the masses and we've relaxed to a different theta equilibrium. Go to the same thing, user-defined exponential decay. We're going to use that, so click there, and fit. We picked a peak at 1930.3 seconds. At 1933.1 seconds, we might as well go on out to around 2500 seconds. We'll stick in our initial guesses. That's not where that goes. That goes down here. Yes, 0.02. Now we'll put in 1933.1. And we'll just give it a round of ballpark initial guesses. And let's hit fit, and then we'll give it a green line, although you can't see the green line because it doesn't come up well enough. It's actually sitting there exactly on the data. And now the parameters are all sped onto the graph, but we can resize them and we can analyze them. And now let's compare them. I told you that the left-hand side has a lower frequency than the right-hand side. So W1 on the right-hand side is 0.044, W1 on the left-hand side is 0.025. So the data is crap. I'm so sad. Get your own data. But now you know how to analyze it. Okay, goodbye.